Howdy, Longhorns. We hope your Thanksgiving break was fun and restful. I'm Andrea, and this is the 13th edition of the Longhorn Student News at George Ranch High School.
Everybody, I'm Madison. The Longhorns' run in the UIL football playoffs is over after the humble Wildcats beat George Ranch 20-21 at TDECU Stadium. Here are some highlights from the game, video courtesy of Mr. Tubes and audio courtesy of GRHS iRadios, Chris Elliott, Coach Floyd, and Mr. T.
The George Ranch Longhorns postseason play is over on the gridiron after the humble Wildcats beat GR 28-21 at TDECU Stadium on the campus of the University of Houston. George Ranch drew first and second blood in this area round game. The first TD came on a Sam Miller to Javon Gibson pass and catch. Here's GRHS iRadio's Chris Elliott and Quantus Floyd on the call.
Third and 21. Fake a give. Sam, deep ball. Man falls. Javon, touchdown.
What a play.
Third and 21, no problemo.
When you got Gibson in the game, it is not a problem. Right up top, just an easy go route, a nine route. They didn't put a hand on him. He just ran right by the cornerback who stumbled out of his break. And what a play by Gibson. Way to put us on top early here in the first quarter.
Javon Gibson is emerging here in the area on the back end of this season as a legit number wide receiver, number one for those fantasy geeks out there. And you see it all the time, Coach. The DB, he panicked. He fell down.
As soon as the ball was released, he just like he stumbled. He just saw the ball in the air and he knew he wasn't going to be able to make a play on it.
The point after was good by Carlos Villagomez, and the Longhorns led 7-0. The next score also came on a pass play from Sam Miller, but this time he found Andre Falque all alone for George Ranch's second TD. Once again, let's join Chris, Coach Floyd, and yours truly for the call.
An absolutely gorgeous afternoon for football. Sam looks right, pumps left, wide open, pump and go, touchdown, Andre Falque.
What a play. They faked it out to Javon. What made it happen is that they faked it to Javon Gibson. They're all nervous because Javon has already hit him up top. It was a screen, a fake screen, a bubble go is what we used to call it, a bubble streak by the inside receiver. Soon as he faked it, two guys came up trying to make a play on Gibson, and it was wide open for the homecoming king, Andre Falk.
King Andre, he said. The senior.
I got to say this about that second Longhorns touchdown. A good throw by Sam Miller, a good catch by Falque, but you got to credit Sam Miller with that shoulder shake and that shimmy he put in it before he threw the ball. It froze that corner, and Falque, heading towards the end zone, was all by himself to catch that one and jump into the end zone.
The extra point was wide of the goalposts, and the Longhorns led 13-0 before the Wildcats scored before half. The teams went into the locker room with the Longhorns leading 13-7. Humble scored twice early in the second half and led the Longhorns by 8, 21-13. George Ranch needed a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie things up. Then this happened.
Tonight is Fabian Marks in the offensive formation. Sam, straight drop, deep throw. Javon's behind the defense. Caught! See you later! 74 yards right on cue, Coach. We needed a big play and a highlight film catch. Contested catch 45 yards downfield. And Coach Q's got two fingers up as the horns should be going for two here. And the offense just figured it out.
Javon Gibson just being able to beat the corner at the line of scrimmage and just make that play, extending his arms all the way out to make that fingertip grab and just to bring it home for us.
Two-point conversion on the way. Razzle dazzle from the horn.
Philly special.
Andre, Philly special. It's Andre Falque on the Philly Philly. Sam Miller on the reception. And deep into his bag of tricks goes Coach Cavallo.
Wow. If y'all remember back in the two Super Bowls ago. What a great play call by Coach O. That's what they ran against Patriots. Philadelphia Eagles ran against the Patriots to score a touchdown by Nick Foles, the Texas native. Right there we hit Sam Miller, letting him be a playmaker in the back of the end zone. Great job by Andre Farquhar, because Farquhar is our backup quarterback, so it's just a quarterback-to-quarterback connection.
It looked, while the ball was in the air, that it may have been just a touch too far. So then Sam put the afterburners on and extended, similar to Javon. They both had to extend to make those catches. But momentum, we talked about it. The Horns offense has held serve, if you will. They've done their job. Now, Coach, it's on the defense to get a stop and get the ball back to their O.
And I think right now, with that momentum coming our way, and especially with two young teams, first time in the playoffs, two young teams, Humble haven't been there for 10 years. We missed.
The Wildcats scored again in the fourth quarter and led 28-21. George Ranch needed to get the ball back to have one last shot at tying or winning the game. Let's join Chris and the coach for the call.
Second and nine. Weibel, straight drop, looking for Williams left. Now he comes over the middle. Seth is there, picked off. Hughes got it, looking for a block left side. He's looking for the boundary. He's up to the 30, and he'll be thumped out of bounds at the 34-yard line. But what a play, folks. That's the answer that the D needed. It was senior Seth McVay who got the pass defense. Ball popped up in the air, and Q with his fourth INT on the season. That's another young man that's going to contribute on the hardwoods, I believe, for Coach Jones and yourself.
Oh, yeah, they're doing a great job there. Q just being where he should be, and a great job on the tip and play. That, listen, I want to take away the run. That's what we have to do.
George Ranch had the ball but failed to push it across the goal line, and the season ends at 5-7 with a 28-21 loss to Humble.
Five Longhorns, in the spirit of Christmas, we found some admin and teachers to perform some TikToks. Roll the clips.
All I want for Christmas is you.
Class of 2020 and a member of the 10th anniversary yearbook staff here at the ranch. We're very excited about the 2020 yearbook. Our theme is Full Circle, a retrospective scrapbook celebrating Miss Patterson's inaugural Polly Ryan class that has now become her first graduating class. And the book is a look back on our school's awesome 10-year history. As you can see, our cover has a distinct retro look to it, from the colors to the shapes and even the font we used. It'll be a one-of-a-kind keepsake that you just have to have. And if you're a senior like me, your family and friends can purchase a senior tribute ad in the yearbook just for you. Don't miss out. Order yours today. Go to Balfour.com or come by Mr. Toronto's room, 1419, and pick up an order form.
Next week is our last news broadcast for 2019, and we'll have more holiday segments for you, including pictures from staff holiday displays, more TikToks, and a tour of the Always Believe display at Mr. Tube's house. So for Andrea and Madison, I'm Maya. We'll see you next time with more student news from George Ranch High School in Richmond, Texas. Have a great week, Longhorns. Hey! Hey! Hey!